In a time before the gods went to war, before the coming of Alaloth, there were four great kingdoms. The Republic of Larastir, the Blessed Kingdom of Edirhest, the Desolation of Baga, and the Expanse of Catacomb. Each kingdom, a collection of houses, championing the virtues of the kingdom. Yet this was before Alaloth, and the War of the Gods. During this pantheonic conflict, many gods were wounded and fell. At war's end, Alaloth, the great betrayer, stood above them all in triumph, casting his ominous shadow across the world. At his command, mighty tempest, spears of lightning, and dark energy rained down upon the land. Dragons, beasts, and other foul creatures not seen for millennia have appeared again, besieging the kingdoms with fire and death. These vicious creatures rage unchecked, laying waste to any and all in their path. And from the shadows, the spectral circle, worshippers of Alaloth conduct dark rites and whisper secrets designed to seed unrest, lay the faithful low, and drive allies apart, all in service to their hateful god. And they are succeeding. Where once the kingdoms stood together against all threats, they have now turned on each other, suspicious and vengeful. The war that once consumed the gods looks as though it will soon consume the kingdoms as well. And so it falls to a few, a band of champions, and whatever allies they can gather to find a way to bring peace to the kingdoms and end Alaloth's reign once and for all. Are you prepared? The dwarves of Catacombs are strangely optimistic. As much as they rarely show fear, they rarely show fatalism as well. They see life as a series of battles, but unlike the orcs, it's not status they seek. Of all the races, the dwarves have weathered the unrest the best, seeing it as the ultimate challenge. They have welcomed refugees and traitors from all kingdoms, promising safety and shelter to those who wish to reside in their halls. The dwarves have not been untouched by recent troubles, but they have suffered less than other races. When Alaloth came to the mortal realms, his arrival shattered some of the underground dwarven kingdoms bordering the Valley of Storms, and it's said some of his essence bled into the stone there. If mined and retrieved, it could be used as a powerful weapon against the fallen god, but it's had other unintended consequences for the region. Thank you.
Ah! We'll be right back.
Deep into the mountain, all will find the great halls of the dwarves. Marvelous craftsmanship with every arch and forge stands proudly for generations past. Clan Karak, the house of the first dwarven architects who laid stone and hammer to craft and build, continues the traditions of the precursor race which once roamed these caverns and always seeks their hidden knowledge.
You name it, I got it.
grab it the best armor in town.
The Tomb of a Legend, the Nemesis of Necromancy, Volkar the Brave. The crypt was given to the late warrior for his valorous death in the battle against Kariasha and for saving the world. The site had become a pilgrimage spot in the centuries that followed, but lately the dead that were buried with him have risen, and Volkar's tomb was abandoned.
Thank you. Yeah.